back, Alex.
Morning.
Lovely to have you here without your partner in crime. No Hamish this week.
No, he's on holiday.
Okay.
Right, well, actually, we can get some information out there.
I know. Okay, so we'll achieve a whole lot more this morning.
Yeah, that's right. What are we talking about this weekend? Because it is the weekend. What are we going to do?
We're going to make some planter boxes.
Nice. Mm-hmm. I made a planter box last year. I made a fatal error, but I'll point out where I went wrong after you've told us how you built yours.
Okay.
I'm assuming yours fell to pieces or something.
Yeah, I'll tell you at the end.
Yeah, probably.
Okay, step one.
It's the first step.
This is actually quite a simple DIY project, and I made one of these a couple of years ago, and I had some spare timber left over from doing some fencing, which wasn't the actual correct timber that you should use because it'll rot much quicker. Mm-hmm. But I figured, a couple of years I'll get sick of this one, I'll make something else, you know. But if you're going to go out and get the bits and pieces that you need to get H3.2 preserved timber, which will not rot.
Okay, did you write that down?
Yeah, I've got it.
All right. So quite simple. You need a drop saw, you need a drill and a drill bit and some stainless steel screws because they won't rust.
Okay, so so you've got your stuff, now what?
Right, start with the bottom of the planter box because for a start it's the bit you don't see. So as you get your eye in for getting your DIY hands dirty, you can make a few mistakes and doesn't have to be quite right, you know? but you've got your drop saw, so it should be. So you cut your pieces to whatever the length is that you want your planter box to be.
Right,
you can see that.
There.
It's, of course, a fairly square-shaped one
right.
that we've got on screen. And it's that retaining timber, which is tongue and groove, so it all slots together nicely so there's no gaps.
Okay.
All right, so that's job one.
So far, so good.
Okay. Yeah, so far, so good. Yeah, sure.
Step two, do the sides. So it's got four sides. Okay.
He's using the voice of us.
Please,
he's
still here.
He's using his special voice, isn't he?
All right.
Do you guys get it? Do you understand it? Yes, we do.
And they, again, obviously need to be the same size as the base, but you can be as big or as small as you want your planter box to be, and you screw them at the sides. But the retaining timber with that tongue and groove, you slot it in on the top and you grow your levels of sides to however high you want your box to be.
Okay.
Oh, yeah,
and that's fairly rigid and solid as it is.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
The reason that you use screws rather than nails is because you will plant something in there, the roots will grow, and if it's something quite big, they'll start to push the sides of the box out.
Right. Okay? So screwing holds it together better.
Correct. Yep.
So how are you going?
You're with me?
Oh, I've done everything correctly so far. Yes.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Now, once you've got your sides on, you've got your desired height, mm-hmm. turn it over, put the base in and put some feet on it.
Yes.
So that your water can drain out of it and doesn't just sit there rotting away in the damp.
And there it is. That's mm-hmm. what I did.
So you put feet on your planter box.
I didn't put feet on my planter box, and now the bum of my planter box has broken away.
Yeah.
Which is never
rookie
a good
mistake.
Rookie
Mike.
Mistake.
Rookie
yeah.
mistake.
Embarrassing. Yeah.
Okay, so you've got all that done. How do you finish it off? What products do you use?
Well, you can leave it as it is if you want, but it'll go that sort of grey colour that timber does. Or you could stain it with some resin waterborne woodsman penetrating oil, because that'll soak in nicely and it'll stay there and it'll look nice for a while. Or lumberside paint if you want to go for a colour. And I happen to have some knocking around because it's pretty similar to what you might paint your weatherboards of your house with, and I'd done that relatively recently, so I had the paint, so there you go, job done.
And resin do a lot of different colour stains, don't they?
So yeah, absolutely. So you can go into your local resin store and get the colour charts and have a look and get some advice, because they're actually really good at giving you the right advice on what product to use. Or go to resin.co.nz.
Sorry, I feel I was hurrying you there, wasn't I?
You were, weren't you?
I feel like we got a whole lot of information.
We did, actually.
There you see.
Very constructive.
I'm not used to it, because usually when it's you and Hamish, there's a lot of this and not so much of this. Anyway, thank you, Alex.
That's right. He texted me this morning saying, hey, are you going to be all right? And I went, yeah, I'll be fine.
Yeah, I'll be all right. Anyway, we do miss him, but it's been great to have you in. And we'll see you again next week.